Hey guys, it's Victoria and welcome back to FemmeHead. Today I want to talk about how I chose my provider for pregnancy. Is it your prenatal birth provider situation? Because I think it's interesting to hear kind of people's thought processes and also just to share some of the options, and it's different depending on where you live. For getting to a point to where you're thinking about getting pregnant, or you want to start trying, or you are pregnant and you're looking into providers, they don't want to see you until you're like 8 to 12 weeks pregnant anyway, so you still have time once you find out that you're pregnant to find the provider that works for you. And it's also okay to switch providers. I just talked to a lady the other day who I think it was 34 weeks, left her OBGYN and ended up going with a midwife, I wanna say. Even though it's stressful, it's possible. I've gotten a couple odd messages / comments about this decision. I mean, I know there's always gonna be opinions out there, but it's just such a very personal thing. And when you are pregnant and giving birth, it is your choice. So if you want a certain thing out of pregnancy and labor and birth, you gotta make that decision when you're pregnant. And so, I don't know, don't say weird things to people. So it kind of all started when I watched The Business of Being Born in college, like back in the day, way before I ever wanted to get pregnant. And I was fascinated. I have watched it like 10 times since. I love it. I want to watch it again. But that was kind of the first time I had ever thought about, what do I want out of my experience of pregnancy, labor, and birth? Think about the options out there. I always thought, like through college and into my early 20s, that I wanted to have a home birth and I wanted a water birth. That was the road I was gonna go down. And so that's definitely when we started thinking about like, okay, the time's coming up that we wanna start trying. I was looking for midwives in the area and I found a really awesome birthing clinic here in town. And that was my top contender. And then my best friend got pregnant and her baby's like 8 months old. She went to a midwife clinic in town. That was one I hadn't heard about or hadn't considered, because I was definitely looking at the birth center because you could do home births. So I started looking into this clinic that she went to and I was really interested, and because it is associated with the hospital, it is covered by insurance, which unfortunately, and it's like a very frustrating thing, the birth center is not. And I think that is just something that needs to change. Like, I don't understand why insurance companies don't want to cover midwives, because it's going to cost them so much less money. But that's a topic for another day. So these were kind of our two options. And then when we did get pregnant, or I think it was before actually, these are the options I presented to Michael. Like, hey, I'm teetering between this birth center and this midwife clinic. What do you think? Our happy medium was the midwife clinic, because he wasn't super comfortable with a home birth, and I get that. It is scary when you don't know what to expect, and if something does go wrong, not to say that something is going wrong, like so often nothing goes wrong, but also we live in an apartment, and from my perspective, and I know people all over the world give births in apartments and have beautiful home births in apartments, but just knowing my brain and knowing that I have people above me, below me, next to me, I would be self-conscious about that during labor, being like, oh my God, what do these people think? Are they gonna call the cops because they think that I'm dying or someone's murdering me, especially if it's in the middle of the night that I'm laboring, blah, 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 blah. We went with the midwife clinic and I'm so happy with that decision. If you don't know my whole like pregnancy journey situation, we got pregnant last summer and ended up having a blighted ovum miscarriage at 9 weeks. And we went to this midwife clinic for our first appointment, and the love and care and like just empathy they showed in that situation, not even knowing me, like this was my first time in, it sealed the deal. Like everyone from the secretary to the nurses to the midwives were just so aware and conscious of my emotions and everything in that situation, that I remember, like I held it together at the time, but I remember like leaving the clinic and like walking out and like starting to blubber a bit and saying to Michael, when it comes time, I wanna go back there, sort of thing. How they handled that situation was just so awesome that I was like, I'm going back there with our next pregnancy. So how it works in this situation, and every situation is different, is I have a clinic full of midwives. It's a weird term. I have a clinic that I go to for all of my prenatal appointments, and they have several midwives on staff. Oh, I wanna say like around 7, like that number, a couple more, a couple less. That's where I go for all of my prenatal appointments. When time comes to give birth, I will go to a local hospital that they are affiliated with, and I will give birth in the hospital by the midwife that is on call that day, night, whenever it is. So each time I go to appointment, I see a different midwife, so I get to meet them all. And so far they all have been lovely and I enjoy all of them and they're really amazing. But kind of the idea is you see all of them throughout your pregnancy. So when it comes time to give birth, you already know the midwife on call, you've had an appointment with her, she has had experience with you, and la-di-da-di-da, that goes great. Everything that I've asked them about, like, oh, how do you guys feel about this or that? They're like, oh yeah, that we just do that normally. And we're definitely in the same wavelength when it comes to laboring desires, afterbirth desires. They're very open and flexible with like how you labor. The only thing is I can't give birth in a tub. I can labor in the tub, but I can't give actual birth in there, which is like, it's fine. I think just for getting through the stages of labor, having a tub as an option will be really nice. And I've also heard of women who are planning to have a water birth and they get the tub for their home and everything, and they end up giving birth in bed because that just is what is more comfortable. So you never know what you're going to want in that situation. And I'm just trying to go into it with a very open, flexible, welcoming, easygoing mindset of, yeah, these are the things I want. These are the things that I don't want to compromise on, but also you never know what's going to happen. And that doesn't mean it's going to turn out bad, but you just have to be open to the possibilities of things outside what you have planned for. And I think that just makes the experience not easier maybe, but maybe a better experience. I can definitely see a home birth in my future. I'm so happy with what we've chosen to go with. And like I said before, like we live in an apartment and I know if I don't feel good and I feel sick, like either cramping or vomiting or whatever, like I don't get sick very often, but I want to be by myself. And I don't want people to know I'm sick. I don't want people to stand there and watch me be sick or hear me. And I know you might think that you have more control over that in your home rather than a hospital, but in a labor and delivery ward, they see everything day in and day out. And in your apartment building, they don't necessarily know what's going on. And I think I would be more self-conscious in an apartment with just fully giving into labor than I would in a hospital. And I've kind of come to some realizations about myself and how I think I'm gonna approach labor, but I can talk about that later on. I'm still kind of not formalizing my birth plan because I'm not really going in with a birth plan other than like a few certain things that I want. Overall, I'm pretty flexible, but I think once I kind of solidify some methods and practices, I will make a video about that because I've discovered a few things recently and I feel very inspired by them. This is just simply to share how I kind of went about choosing my provider. Like I said, I can definitely see a home birth in the future. That's something that really interests me and excites me, but I am so excited for the prospect of actual labor and birth and that experience and like everything that comes along with it. I kind of feel like a freak. Like I was so excited to experience pregnancy and I'm so excited to experience labor. And I know some people are terrified of labor and birth, but bring it on. Like I can't wait. I'm so excited. That is what I have to say today about how I chose my provider, how Michael and I chose our provider, I guess. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. If you enjoyed this type of content, hit the subscribe button to follow along with me and the whole journey of it all. I do vlog style videos on my second channel, Victoria Zimmerman, where I give more pregnancy updates and that sort of stuff. If you want to go check that out, that's always in the description box. But yeah, if you guys have any questions about this, or this has prompted a desire for me to make a video related to this or kind of going off of this, let me know down in the comment section. But thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.